I was diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. I remember dreaming and praying that I'd be alive long enough to play Survivor again. And so it is a miracle that I'm sitting here today. Going through cancer, you know, it's hard, but life after cancer, you know, that's when it really got tough. Fear of relapse, the fear of death, it's with you all the time. It's not a way to live your life. And being here, saying yes to an all-winners edition of Survivor, this is living. And I want to, like, resurrect that 27-year-old, like, young, innocent guy to come back and play this game, the game that I love, the game that changed my life. And so I'm back, and I'm ready to play, and everyone better watch out. The pace of the game is warp speed. I am so unaccustomed to this. I have no clue what's going on.
I feel like I'm going to throw up right now. At this point, I'm with Rob.
I was hoping to have a little bit more time to get into the groove, but there's no time for that.
So, Ethan, let's start with just the culture shock of being back out living in a jungle, sleeping on bamboo. What's it been like?
I mean, the pace of this game is shocking to me. Compared to the last time I played, that was like glacial speed.
You're not even talking about shelter, you're just talking about strategy.
Oh yeah, were you talking about shelter?
Dude, you suck today.
Bro.
Bro, I tried hard.
You weren't much better.
No.
I know I'm kind of on the outs. Herbie and I were like close to the beginning, and she doesn't hardly talk to me at all anymore, and I thought we were together, but I feel like you already know you're on the outs when that happens. So, I just want to make my case with you guys.
And what is your conversations with Rob and Mike?
The other day, he said, you know, he wanted to stay old school strong, but it was a short conversation.
You know he's not.
Yeah, you know, I'm not an old schooler, right?
Yeah, no, I know, but I mean.
A little awkward.
No.
Oh my God. We had a plan at the very beginning. It was kind of an old school thing. Obviously, we need to keep it on the DL, but Danny, right in front of Ben, comes out with it. You know, I don't really know what's going on with Danny. I think she feels like she's on the outside, and now she's telling Ben all of our secrets.
And Ethan, how does that manifest itself through the eyes of somebody like you who has not played in a long time?
It's quite confusing, to be honest, reading people and understanding if my relationship is real or if this is just a new side of the game that I just don't understand.
Ethan, losing does make unity very hard to find. And when you don't have it, people out of desperation start to just look out for themselves.
Yeah, you know, certain people are working with certain people and information comes to you in a variety of different ways. So you kind of gotta take care of yourself. I just want to get through this vote. Like, this is the most important moment for me right now. And I gotta play right now.
So does that mean that you don't really think that much ahead?
I do, but like, I can't think too far ahead if I'm not in the game anymore.
Fourth person voted out of Survivor, Winners at War. Ethan.
Hello, it's Ethan.
Shut up.
I think my alliance with Boston Rob and Parvati didn't go so well. I'm not afraid of Edge of Extinction because I've been to the edge of extinction having to go through cancer. So I think I have the mental strength to get through it. Night one on Extinction wasn't great. But right now I feel defeated. I feel a little bit lost. There's not much stopping me from going over and raising the flag right now. Probably pride. Probably just I did put in so much time and effort and preparation, and so many people did support me getting to this point that I feel I owe it to them. And if I can't do it for myself, I want to do it for them. And I think there will be this process of mourning my own death on Survivor and kind of this rebirth here on Edge of Extinction, and I hope I can take advantage of that rebirth and learn something about myself, learn something about the people around me, let it sit, let it breathe, and then I'll kind of gotta refocus and build myself back up to be strong for the upcoming challenges.
Today you each have a chance to earn a fire token.
Woo!
But it will require tremendous effort. At the top of the steps are four piles of firewood. You must bring down all 20 pieces from your pile and stack them next to your fire, one piece at a time.
Cheers. First trip up the hill was pretty good. So in my mind, I think, oh, 20 times, this is gonna be so bad. I mean, I've done marathons.
college. I play professional soccer. I've been through cancer. We have till sundown to do this? Yeah, piece of cake. Self-doubt crept in around log 10. Definitely. I wanted to be first, and then I scrapped that concept, and then I realized I just gotta get it done.
Pick it up. Pick it up. Pick it up.
You okay?
Yeah.
Stop. Sit.
Yeah, no, I just did. It's a tough challenge right now, and I'm struggling to get through it. I'll go until my legs collapse, or the sun goes down. I may not finish, but I'm not gonna stop.
Hey, Ethan. How you doing? I'm gonna take your blood pressure and your temperature, okay? Feeling lightheaded? Yeah.
Major.
You feel like you're gonna faint? Yeah?
All the time.
Okay. Let's have a look at you. Your blood pressure is low, and if you're feeling faint, then it's likely that you will faint. Like, it doesn't get better from running up and down, okay? That feeling won't go away.
I'm so, like, disappointed in myself. Like, I just wanted to, like, complete this for myself. I'd already put in 16 trips. I had 4 more trips to finish this thing. I just did not want to quit. I wanted to set a good example for, like, everyone who's been through a health challenge and thinks they can't do it anymore. Like, you can do it. You can get through those hard moments. And I just sucked it up.
You got this. You've been through a lot worse things.
Like, I kept saying to myself, like, remember when you were, like, getting spinal taps, when you were getting radiation, and I started saying, like, the mantras I was using when I was getting chemotherapy to kind of get me through these hardest moments. And I was like, remember, 7 years ago, you were locked in a hospital room, close to death.
After seeing how much Ethan struggled and still pick himself up, it was inspiring. It was incredible.
They all went with me to finish the last leg, which was pretty touching.
Last one!
Log!
Woohoo!
I all of a sudden realized the bond that we've created in this very short time.
That was something I will remember for the rest of my life.
That feels good.
Thank you, everyone.
Nice job, guys.
Life on edge of extinction is a battle. Every day is a battle with elements and nature. Every day is a battle with my own personal struggle of why am I here? Why am I sticking it out? And how to exist in this in-between world. So it's just, it's depressing. I feel defeated. There's like no hope. But you gotta find that hope someplace, because without it, you're just gonna destroy yourself.
We'll catch and fish.
How good it's gonna feel when you're done.
I know. I'm so excited for that.
Mm-hmm. And it's only just a matter of time.
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm good. I just had moments. This couldn't be good for me, my body.
Doing this? Are you gonna pull the flag?
No, but think about it. It's just like, there's no long-term data on
if you want.
People who have gone through stem cell transplants. My body's not the same as it once was. Like, chance to grow inside me, you know? I think about that all the time.
I can talk to Parvati. I feel really comfortable with her, so that's a big help, because, you know, she keeps me strong. It gives me a little bit of inspiration to keep going. I want a chance to win, get back in the game, and have a shot at that $2 million. It's not out of the question. Like, I've come back from the edge of extinction twice due to my health, so I know what that's like. I came to play Survivor. I want to give it 100% and see it through to the end, because it's important to me.
God, it's our family!
There's nothing. You're the most important thing in my life. Like, there's nothing on this planet that is more important than you. Like, I don't want to ever be away from you ever again.
No.
Ever. Not for a day. Like,
no.
I love you so much.
I will always have that moment that I shared with my wife here on Edge of Extinction. And that is, like, so special. I'm going to approach a challenge like I approach any challenge. Give it 100%, hope for the win,
and just do my best.
But it's a little unnerving knowing that there's a few people that have one advantage. Natalie's gonna have three advantages and an idol plus a surplus of tokens. I got nothing.
You know, Survivor Africa changed my life. Because of Survivor, we launched Survivor Stand Up to Cancer, which has raised millions of dollars for cancer research. And I don't know if many people know this, but some of the money raised through Survivor Stand Up to Cancer helped fund the drug that saved my life.
Wow.
So not only did it like create a life for me, this show saved my life. Not too long ago, like I was battling a rare form of blood cancer. Like I just wanted to live one more day. And I was thinking to myself, like, if I get out of this transplant alive, I want to play Survivor. And I prayed and I dreamed that I could get myself healthy enough to be able to, like, come out here and play again. And I did. For me, this is, like, the perfect bookend on this crazy and amazing life that Survivor has gifted me. And I'm so grateful and honored to be part of this crew right here. So I truly appreciate that. And thank you, everyone.